In this lecture, we are going to see the concepts of Unit 3. Unit 3 title is Context-Free Grammar and Languages. Already we know what is a language. It is a set of strings. And in this unit, we will see what is grammar and what is context-free grammar. These are the topics to be discussed in this lecture. Grammar, types of grammar, CFG, languages, derivations, ambiguous grammar and parsed. We will see one by one. Let us start with the grammar. Already we know the language is used to represent the finite automata. So we can represent the finite automata for any language. The automata either may be DFA or NFA. And also we can easily describe the particular language which is accepted by the finite automata in a easy expression manner. That expression is known as regular expression. So every language, each and every languages of the finite automata can be represented by some grammar. So this is the grammar concept. So the grammar can be written as by using four tuples: capital N, capital T, capital S and capital P. So each and every term have some meaning. Capital N is nothing but variable or non-terminal symbols. Capital T is a set of terminal symbols, or it is a set of input alphabets, and capital S is a start symbol, it is a special variable, and capital P is the production rules in a grammar. So let us see one example, then you can clear knowledge about what are these four tuples in a grammar. This is the grammar, that is capital S tends to AB. This is the first production, and the second production is capital A tends to small a, and the third production is capital B tends to small b. So in this particular grammar, there are three protections. So the capital N is a set of variables or non-terminal symbols. So usually the variables are the uppercase letters, and the terminal symbols are lowercase letters, that is small case letters, symbols, digits and epsilon. These are the terminal symbols. Uppercase letters are called as non-terminal symbols or variables. And the capital S is a start symbol. Here there are three production rules in a grammar. So the first production is S tends to AB. So the left hand side symbol is S and the right hand side symbol is AB. So the left hand side symbol is the start symbol, but it is a first production because here there are three productions. But the leftmost symbol or variable of the first production is nothing but a start symbol. It is a special variable. So here what are the non-terminals are? Capital S, capital A, capital B, because capital letters are non-terminals. So what are the terminal symbols? That is small a and small b. So this is terminal symbols. And last one is capital P. So protection rules are, there are three protections: S tends to AB, A tends to A and B tends to B. Let us see another example. So this is the another grammar. Grammar tends to, the first production is S tends to A, capital A, B. Second production is small a, capital A tends to A, capital A, B, comma, capital A tends to epsilon. So here there are three protections in a grammar. From this grammar, we can easily write what is capital N, non-terminal, what is capital T, terminal, what is S, start symbol, and what are the protection rules, that is capital P, because these four tuples are consist of in a grammar. So we will see one by one. First one is capital N, that is non-terminal. Non-terminals are uppercase letters. So what are the non-terminals in this grammar? Capital S and capital A. There are only two capital letters. So the non-terminals capital N indicate capital S and capital A. So the second tuple is capital T. So terminal symbols are lowercase letters, that is small case letters and digits, numbers, symbols, epsilon symbol. These are the lowercase letters. So here the lowercase letters are small a and small b, and epsilon symbol is also there. So terminals are a, comma b and epsilon. So this is terminal symbol. Third tuple is capital S, that is start symbol. In a grammar there are multiple productions, but start symbol is nothing but the left hand side symbol or variable of the first production. It is otherwise called as head of the production. Here the first production is capital S tends to small a capital A B. So the head of the production or left hand side symbol of the first production is capital S. So the start symbol of this grammar is capital S. And the last one is P, that is protection rules. Here there are three protection rules. First one, second one, third one. So there are three production rules. So this is nothing but grammar. So each and every language can be represented by some grammar. That grammar having four tuples, N, T, S, P, non-terminals or variables, terminals, start symbol and protection rules. So according to Homsky hierarchy, the grammars can be divided into four types: type 0, type 1, type 2 and type 3. Type 0 is known as unrestricted grammar, type 1 known as context sensitive grammar, type 2 known as context free grammar, and type 3 known as regular grammar. So this is the hierarchy diagram for all these types of grammar. So grammar having four types: type 0, type 1, type 2 and type 3. So each and every grammar having the self loop of the another type of the particular grammar. So the inner loop of the grammar is regular, type 3, then type 2, then type 1 and type 3. So what is the meaning of this diagram? In the sense, type 0 include all the other three types of grammar. Type 1 include type 2 and type 3 grammar. Type 2 grammar include type 3 grammar. So this is the meaning of this diagram. And we will see one by one. The first type is unrestricted grammar. In the word sense, it is nothing but a grammar which don't have any restrictions on the protection rules of that grammar. That grammar is called as unrestricted grammar. So the second type is type 1, which is also called as context sensitive grammar. It is also called as, and the context sensitive grammar generate the context sensitive languages, and which satisfy two properties. The first property is this grammar should be type 0. Already we see in the diagram. So type 1 grammar should be type 0, and the number of symbols in the left hand side should be less than the number of symbols on the right hand side, which is the most important property of type 1 grammar. Again I repeat, the first property is type 1 grammar should be type 0, that is context unrestricted grammar. Second property, the number of symbols in the left hand side symbol of the production should be less than or smaller than the number of symbols on the right hand side of the protection. So these two properties should satisfied by type 1 grammar. Then type 2 grammar is called as context free grammar, CFG. It is also called as CFG. So CFG generate context free language. It should satisfy two properties. The first property is type 2 grammar should be type 1, that is the above grammar, and type 1 grammar also it should be type 0 grammar. So type 2 grammar includes type 1, type 0, right? So the second property is the left hand side of the production should have only one variable, that is these are the context free grammar, because you can see the left hand side having only one variable, that is capital S, capital A and capital B. But right hand side it may having anything, but left hand side should have only one variable, that is not terminal, it is a variable. That type of grammar is called as context free grammar. So there are two properties. First one is it should be type 1, that is context sensitive grammar. Second one is the left hand side of the production should have only one variable. Then the grammar is called as context free grammar. The last one is regular grammar. So regular grammar is used to generate regular language. We all know what is regular language. So type 0 is most restricted form of grammar. It should be in the given form, the below form of the grammar, that is capital V tends to, V is nothing but variable, that is non-terminal. T is a terminal symbol. So the first form is number of single variable followed by number of non-terminals, because T power having closure properties. Closure means with zero or more times. So a single variable followed by any number of terminals, and also otherwise it having any number of terminals followed by single variable, that is V tends to T star V, means a variable having the protection of which have more than any number of terminals should be followed by a single variable. So this is the form of regular grammar, but we always usually use context-free grammar. So context-free grammar having only one variable in the left-hand side of the production. Usually the production is nothing but, for example, capital A tends to small a, it is a production. So each and every production having left-hand side value and right-hand side value. So CFG, context-free grammar, is nothing but left-hand side value of the given production having only one variable. Then the grammar is called a CFG. Usually we use CFG grammar in the TOC, right? So CFG is nothing but context free grammar. It consists of four tuples. It is also the definition of grammar: non-terminal, terminal, production and start symbol. S is the start symbol. We will see some problems in context free grammar. Here we are going to construct context-free grammar for some languages. In the first unit itself, we can draw the finite automata for any type of languages. Now we are going to construct the grammar for a language, because we will study a new concept grammar in the third unit itself. So now we are going to construct the grammar from any type of the language. So that is the concept of these problems. So the first problem is construct the context-free grammar representing the set of palindromes over the alphabet 0 plus 1 the whole star. Wherever the plus symbol is presented in the regular expressions, that means the input is either 1 or other 1. So here the input alphabet is either 0 or 1 with 0 or more times, because the plus symbol is separated 0 and 1, which means either 0 or 1, but it having closure property, so with the 0 or more times. So the condition is representing the set of palindromes. So we should know before solving the problem what is palindrome. So palindrome is nothing but is a set of strings which gives the same meaning when we perform the operation of reverse of the string, right? இப்போ ஏபிஏ அப்படின்னு ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரிங் இருக்குன்னா அதை நீங்கள் ரிவர்ஸில் போட்டாலும் ஏபிஏன்னு வரும். ஸோ தட் இஸ் பாலிண்ட்ரோம். 010 அப்படின்னு இருக்குன்னா அதை நீங்கள் ரிவர்ஸில் போட்டாலும் 010 வரும். ஸோ தட் இஸ் பாலிண்ட்ரோம் கான்செப்ட். ஸோ நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ட் கண்டெக்ஸ்ட் ஃப்ரீ கிராமர் ஃபார் ரெப்ரசென்டிங் த பாலிண்ட்ரோம், பட் இட் ஹாவ் த இன்புட் ஆல்ஃபபெட் இஸ் எய்தர் 0 or 1 வித் 0 or more times. So the first condition, we have to write the grammar. Grammar is, you all know what is grammar. Grammar having four tuples. It is a production rules, and the production rules having non-terminal and terminal in each and every production. And left-hand side symbol of the production having only one variable, because this is CFG, that is context-free grammar. The main property of CFG is the production, the left-hand side of the production having only one variable. So we are writing. The first step is capital S. Here I am taking capital S, but it is not necessary to take write capital S. You can take any variable, capital A, capital B, anything, but I am taking capital S. So S tends to 0 or 1 or epsilon, because the input alphabet is either 0 or 1. So we are writing S tends to 0. The bar symbol represents R, either 0 or 1. So we can write bar 0 bar 1 bar epsilon, because 0 plus 1 the whole star இருக்கலாம் இல்லாமனாலும் இருக்கலாம். So 0 or 1 or epsilon. So this is the palindrome with length 1. If the palindrome length is greater than 1 in the sense, then we can write another production rule: capital S tends to 0 S 0, or capital S tends to 1 S 1. So for this condition, we have to apply the value for S, but it should satisfy the palindrome property. Consider the first production S tends to 0 S 0. First of all, I am going to substitute epsilon for S, because the first condition we are writing S tends to 0 or 1 or epsilon. So epsilon is substitute for S in the sense. So we can get S tends to 0 0. Now we can reverse the string, then also the result is 0 0. So it is a palindrome. Otherwise, you can substitute 0 or 1 for S. If we can substitute 0 for S, the result is 0 0 0. We can reverse the string, the result is also same, 0 0 0. This is palindrome. Or otherwise, we can substitute 1 for S, so the result is 0 1 0. we can reverse the string. The result is also the same, 010, so it should satisfy the palindrome property. The same concept is used for s tends to 1s1. So this is the grammar protection, should satisfy the palindrome over the alphabet 0 plus 1 the whole star. And in finally we will write all the protections. The first one is s tends to 0 r 1 r epsilon. Second protection, s tends to 0 s 0. Third protection, s tends to 1 s 1. So this is the final result of CFG for a palindrome. So from this grammar you can clearly understand what is variable, what is terminal, what is start symbol and what is protection rule. There are 1 2 3 4 5, there are 5 protection rules, because s tends to 0 one protection, s tends to 1 another protection, s tends to epsilon another protection. Single இருக்கிற ப்ரொடக்ஷன் தான் பார் போட்டு எழுதியிருக்கோம். வி கேன் ரைட் இட் அன் இண்டிவிஜுவல் மேனர் ஆல்சோ. ஸோ த நெக்ஸ்ட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன், ஃபோர்த் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் இஸ் எஸ் டென்ஸ் டு 0 s 0, லாஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் எஸ் டென்ஸ் டு 1 s 1. ஸோ த டெர்மினல்ஸ் ஆர் 0 1 epsilon. ஸோ தேர் ஆர் 3 டெர்மினல்ஸ். நான் டெர்மினல்ஸ் வேரியபிள்ஸ் ஆர் கேபிட்டல் எஸ் ஒன்லி. ஸோ ஸ்டார்ட் சிம்பிள் இஸ் த லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட் சைடு சிம்பிள் ஆஃப் த ஹெட் ஆஃப் தி ப்ரொடக்ஷன், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன். ஹியர் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் இஸ் எஸ் டென்ஸ் டு 0. So the left hand side symbol is S. So start symbol is S. So this is the first problem for constructing the context-free grammar. We will see another problem. The same problem. Construct the CFG for the language L is equal to A power N. The condition is N is odd. So now we are going to construct the grammar. Grammar is nothing but is a set of protection rules. In that protection rules, variables and terminals are going to be present. So the language is L is equal to A power N. The condition is N is odd. So N is odd in the sense N value is 1, N value is 3 and N value is 5 and so on. So we are substituting the value. So we will get the language L is equal to A, comma, triple A, comma, triple 5, comma, 7 A and so on. So for this we are writing the CFG. Now I am taking the start symbol as capital E. You can take any non-terminal, that is capital A, capital B. You can take any alphabet from A to Z, but it should be a it should be a capital letter, not small letter. So capital E tends to small A, because already I said in the first unit, before drawing the finite automata, you can write the language in expanded manner. After that, you can find the common term in all string. First of all, you have to draw the finite automata for the constant terms. After that, you can draw the another input strings. The same concept here. The language, each and every string in a language having single A is a common term. So first of all, I am going to assign the single A for a single non-terminal, that is capital E tends to small A. After that you can take capital E tends to small a capital E. Otherwise you can write it as small a capital E small a. Now you can apply the capital E value for the second production, capital E having small a. So a, another A substituting in the sense, also you having a 5a and 7a, it is going on. So the CFG for this language is E tends to A and E tends to small a capital E, otherwise small a capital E small a. So this is the CFG for the given language. This is another example, that is language L is equal to WC W power R. Here also we are going to construct CFG for the input alphabet either A or B with 0 or more times, because A plus B the whole star. So either A or B with 0 or more times. Here W is a set of strings and W power R is the reverse of the particular string and C is a separator symbol. For example, for W taking AB, so then AB C, reverse of the W is BA. So the result is ABCBA. So this is the language. For this language, we will construct the CFG. So now I am assigning the C separator symbol for one non-terminal, that is capital E tends to small c. Then I am taking only the input symbol A, because it is the concept of either A or B, because the plus symbol is present. So capital E turns to small a, capital E small a, then capital E turns to small b, capital E capital B. Now we can apply the capital E value from the first production C, then you can get small a C small a, small b C small b. So in this result will going on and satisfy the above language condition. So likewise, you can construct the context-free grammar for any type of language. Before constructing the context-free grammar, you can expand the given language by applying the condition in a language. After that, you should identify the common term in each and every string in a particular language. After that, first you can assign the common term to a particular variable, then you can assign another terminals or variables to the variables. So this is the concept of context-free grammar. This is also the another example. Here you can construct the context-free grammar for the set of strings of one or more zeros followed by an equal number of ones. The same problem, the same concept is applied here. First of all, you have to write the language. After that, from this language, you can write the context-free grammar, right? So the next concept is, now the grammar and context-free grammar and types of grammar concept is over. So grammar is used to each and every language represented by some grammar which having four tuples, variable, terminal, protection and start symbol. Second, we saw the types of grammar, type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3. Type 2 is context-free grammar. We usually use the type 2 grammar, that is context-free grammar. Next, we saw about context-free grammar, the same concept of grammar. In that topic, we saw the four problems in context-free grammar. We can construct the context-free grammar for any type of language. First of all, you have to write the language. After that, you can easily write the context-free grammar from that language, right? So the next concept is derivation. In the word derivation, it is very familiar to all. So derivation usually is nothing but is a set of statements that are derived from the initial statement to a conclusion statement. That is a derivation. So in that derivation, it having two types. One is leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation. So it is a derivation, but it is leftmost in the sense we have to replace the leftmost variable, that is leftmost derivation. In case we have to replace the rightmost variable, that is that derivation is called as rightmost derivation. We will see one by one. The first one is leftmost derivation. In the leftmost derivation, the input symbols are read from left to right and replaced with the protection rule from left to right, that is leftmost derivation. But in rightmost derivation, the same concept, we have to read the input symbol from we have to read the input symbol and replaced with the production rule from right to left. So leftmost derivation is left to right and rightmost derivation is nothing but right to left. So we will see one example, then you can clearly know the concept. Let us take the grammar. Grammar having set of production rules, E tends to E plus E, E tends to E minus E, E tends to A or B. The input symbol is small a minus b plus a. So from this grammar, we have to derive this input string by applying the leftmost derivation. Is nothing but by expanding or replacing the leftmost variable, that is leftmost derivation. So and also the derivation we will start from the start symbol of the production. So here the start symbol is capital E because it is the head of the production. So capital E tends to E plus E. The first statement is capital E tends to E plus E. Then in you can see only the right hand side of the equal part. So that expression is E plus E. In E plus E, the leftmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, you have to replace another protection rule. So you can see in the grammar, the second protection rule is E tends to E minus E. So here we can substitute E minus E for the leftmost variable capital E. So the second statement is E minus E plus E. In this statement, the leftmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we can substitute the value A. So you can see the third production rule in a grammar is E tends to A. So we can substitute A for E. So the third statement is A minus E plus E. In this statement, the leftmost variable, the first variable is small a, that is terminal, that is not variable, because variable should be a uppercase letter. So the leftmost variable is capital E. So for this capital E, we can substitute B by applying the fourth production rule of the given production. So the fourth statement is A minus B plus E. So here the leftmost variable is capital E, because A and B is a terminal small case letter. So the uppercase letter is capital E, that is variable. So for this variable, we can substitute A by applying the third rule of the given production. So the final statement, we got the input string, that is A minus B plus A. So you can clearly see that we can, starting from the start symbol of the production and expanding to the given input string by replacing the leftmost variable in each and every step. So this concept is known as leftmost derivation. So the same thing to be applied in rightmost derivation, but we can replace with the rightmost variable, that is rightmost derivation. So the same production rule and the same input string. So we will start from the start symbol of the production. So E tends to E minus E. Here in the first statement, the rightmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we can substitute E plus E by applying the first rule. So E is replaced by E plus E. In the second statement, the rightmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we can substitute A, that is the third rule of the given production rule. So the third statement is E minus E plus A. So in the third statement, the rightmost variable is capital E, because first the rightmost symbol is small a, but the small capital A is a terminal symbol, that is not variable. So the rightmost variable is capital E, that is the second symbol. So capital E is replaced by B, that is the fourth production rule of the given grammar. So E is replaced by B. So the fourth statement is E minus B plus A. In that fourth statement, the rightmost variable is capital E. It should be replaced by small a, that is the third rule of the given production. So now we got the input string which is given in the problem by applying the production rules of the given grammar by replacing the rightmost variable. So this concept is known as rightmost derivation. So you can you got the clear idea about the derivation. This is the derivation. This is also the derivation. This is also the derivation. So the derivation is nothing but is a sequence of statements which start from the initial statement and go to the conclusion statement. That derivation having two types. One is leftmost derivation and the second one is rightmost derivation. So this is an example, one example for leftmost and rightmost derivation. So here one grammar will given as the input, that is S tends to AB bar epsilon, A tends to small a capital B, and B tends to SB, and the input string derivation is a small b small b. So for this grammar, the same concept, for this rule we can derive the input string for leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation. So the first diagram is leftmost derivation and the right one is rightmost derivation. So in leftmost derivation, we will start from the start symbol, that is we can apply substitute AB for A. So the second step, S tends to AB. In AB, the leftmost variable is A, capital A. So for capital A, you can substitute, there is only one production rule, so small a capital B. In the third step, the leftmost variable is capital B. So for capital B, there is only one production in our production rule in the given grammar, so SB is substituted for capital B. Similarly, the steps will be repeated by expanding or replacing the leftmost variable for leftmost derivation. In the final step, we got the input string ABB. The same step for rightmost derivation but applying or replacing the rightmost variable, and also we got the input string ABB. So this is the concept of leftmost and rightmost derivation. The next concept is ambiguity in grammar or ambiguous of grammar. So you know what is grammar. So when a grammar is said to be ambiguous grammar or ambiguity grammar, in the sense, if there exist more than one leftmost derivation or more than one rightmost derivation for the same input string, then the grammar is said to be ambiguous, right? For example, if one grammar production rule is given and one input string is given, for that we can easily derive the particular input string for the above grammar. Either we can use leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation. But for a single grammar and for a single input string, if there exist more than one leftmost derivation or more than one rightmost derivation, then that particular grammar is called as ambiguous grammar. Right, if the grammar is not ambiguous, then it is called as unambiguous, right? So the one example is given, check whether the given grammar is ambiguous or not. So or grammar kudutha and the grammar ambiguous ah illaya nu kepanga, or grammar eppa ambiguous nu solluvom appadina or input string kuduthuruvaanga. So and the grammar vach and the input string na derivation pannuven, either left to most derivation use panni illa right most derivation use panni. More than one left to most derivation apply panniyum same input string same grammar ku enak and the input string output ah kadacha அந்த கிராமரை வந்து ஆம்பிகுவஸ்னு சொல்லுவோம், இல்லை மோர் தென் ஒன் ரைட் மோஸ்ட் டெரிவேஷன் கிடைக்கணும். ஸோ திஸ் கான்செப்ட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ஆம்பிகுவஸ் கிராமர். ஸோ நவு லெட் அஸ் வி வில் செக் இஃப் த கிராமர் இஸ் ஆம்பிகுவஸ் ஆர் நாட். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த கிவன் கிராமர் அண்ட் ஃபார் த கிவன் கிராமர் த இன்புட் ஸ்ட்ரிங் இஸ் ஐடி ப்ளஸ் ஐடி மைனஸ் ஐடி. ஸோ நவு வி கேன் டெரைவ் மோர் தென் ஒன் லெஃப்ட் மோஸ்ட் டெரிவேஷன் ஆர் மோர் தென் ஒன் ரைட் மோஸ்ட் டெரிவேஷன், தென் த அபவ் கிராமர் இஸ் ஆம்பிகுவஸ். So the first leftmost derivation is the same concept. We will start from the start symbol of the production, that is e tends to e plus e, and after this step we can expanding the leftmost variable of the production, that is id for e, and then in the second step the leftmost symbol is e. For e we can substitute e minus e, and similarly the steps will go. Finally we got the input string id plus id minus id. So this is one leftmost derivation. We can do the leftmost derivation in another method, that is we will start from another production e tends to e minus e. Here the leftmost symbol is e, so for e we can substitute e plus e, that is in the second statement, and also the finally we got the output id plus id minus id. So you can clearly see that for the same input string and for the same grammar we can derived some input but using the same leftmost derivation. So here you can have more than one leftmost derivation for the same input string and for the same given grammar, then the above grammar is called as ambiguous grammar. So this grammar is ambiguous grammar because there exists more than one leftmost derivation for the same input string. And the next concept is derivation tree. It is the graphical representation of the derivation, that is nothing but derivation tree. It is also called as parse tree. Once again I repeat, we all know what is derivation. So the graphical representation of that derivation is called as derivation tree, and it is also called as parse tree. The parse tree or derivation tree having some properties. The first one is the root node of the tree always indicating the start symbol of the production. The second property, the derivation is read from left to right manner. And the third property is the leaf node is always the terminal symbols. And last property is the interior nodes are always the non-terminal nodes. The first property is the root of the parse tree is the start symbol. Second property is the derivation is read from left to right. Third property is the leaf nodes are terminal symbols. Fourth property is the interior nodes are non-terminal symbols. Derivation tree is nothing but it is a graphical representation of derivation. It is also called as parse tree. Let us take one example. This is the grammar and they are giving one input string. The grammar having five production. E tends to E plus E. E tends to E star E. E tends to A. E tends to B. E tends to C. அதுதான் அந்த மாதிரி பார் போட்டு எழுதியிருக்காங்க. அண்ட் த இன்புட் ஸ்ட்ரிங் இஸ் ஏ ஸ்டார் பி பிளஸ் சி. ஸோ ஃப்ரம் திஸ் கிராமர் ஃபார் திஸ் இன்புட் ஸ்ட்ரிங் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி டெரைவ் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் இன்புட் ஸ்ட்ரிங் பை யூசிங் எய்தர் லெஃப்ட் மோஸ்ட் டெரிவேஷன் ஆர் ரைட் மோஸ்ட் டெரிவேஷன். நவு வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ட் த டெரிவேஷன் ட்ரீ ஃபார் திஸ் இன்புட் ஸ்ட்ரிங் பை யூசிங் த அபவ் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் ரூல். ஸோ த ஸ்டெப் ஒன் இஸ் வி வில் ஸ்டார்ட் ஃப்ரம் த ஸ்டார்ட் சிம்பிள் ஆஃப் த ப்ரொடக்ஷன். So E tends to, you can draw, it is a tree, so you can draw the node edge, E tends to E plus E. In the second step, in the first step, the leftmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we are substituting E star E in the second step. So in second step, the leftmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we are substituting small a in step 3. So in step 3, the leftmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we are substituting small b in step 4. In step 4, the leftmost variable is capital E. So for capital E, we are substituting small c in step 5. So you can clearly see that the step 5 is a total parse tree. Each and every step is a parse tree, but step 5 is the whole parse tree for the above grammar. So you can check all the properties in this tree. The root node is a start symbol. In this grammar, the start symbol is capital E. In step 5, you can see in step 5. In step 5, the root node is capital E. This is first property. The second property is read the derivation from left to right. You can read the least leaf nodes, that is A star B plus C, which means we can read the derivation from left to right because the input string is given as A star B plus C. The third rule is leaf node is terminal node. You can clearly see that the leaf nodes are terminal. Terminal symbols are lowercase letters and symbols. Here A, B, C, these are the lowercase letter, and star and plus is a symbols. So all five symbols are terminal symbols. The last property is interior nodes are non-terminal nodes. You can clearly see that the interior node only present the capital E. So capital E is nothing but the variable symbol. So this is the concept of derivation tree. It is the graphical representation of derivation. So this is the one problem. So for the given grammar, you can check the particular grammar is ambiguous or not. Either you can prove by using derivation or using the parse tree. You can derive for the particular input string by the grammar. You can use the derivation method, either leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation, or you can using the parse tree, derivation tree, right? So the same concepts are there. And the last concept is relationship between derivation and derivation tree. We all know what is derivation and what is derivation tree. Now we will see about what are the relationship between derivation and derivation tree. Given a grammar is equal to variable, terminal, production and start symbol. So we all know what is derivation. Derivation is nothing but it is a sequence of statement which are starting from the start symbol of the production and concluded with some input string, right? With applying the production rules with zero or more times, that derivation is either maybe leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. You can clearly see the second step, capital A tends to W. And in the above arrow mark, they are indicating one symbol star, that is closure, which means the second step indicating capital A is the start symbol of the, assume capital A is the start symbol of the production, W is the input string. So second step indicating we can derive the input string W from the start symbol of the production capital A by applying the production rules with zero or more times. For that, only in the above arrow mark, they are indicating the closure properties. The third step is capital A tends to W. In the arrow mark above, they are indicating star symbol below LM. LM is nothing but leftmost derivation. It indicates there are some sequence of statements which are derived from the start symbol capital A to the input string W by applying the production rules by expanding the leftmost symbol, that is leftmost derivation. The fourth concept is rightmost derivation. It is similar like leftmost derivation. And the last one is parse tree, that is derivation tree. So from derivation, you can use either leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation and a recursive inference. And finally, we can draw the parse tree or a derivation tree from the leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. This is an equivalence diagram. And inference, recursive, you all know it is a repetition process. And inference is nothing but it is a conclusion statement on the basis of some evidence. That is nothing but inference. So inference means conclusion on the basis of some evidence. So there are three concepts. The first one is from inference to tree. Tree is nothing but derivation tree or parse tree. So inference is nothing but is a conclusion on the basis of embeddings. So here from inference to tree means we are going from conclusion to the tree. That concept is known as from inference to tree. The theorem is the grammar CFG that having four tuples. So the solution is the same one. Here we are going to derive from conclusion to tree. That is nothing but the concept. So to prove, you can clearly see if A tends to W in the above arrow mark, they are indicating closure property. Already explained that there is a parse tree with root symbol A because A is the start symbol. So in the basis step, and we can prove the theorem in TOC concept, we are using only the induction principle. There are two steps in induction principles. One is basis step and another one is inductive step. So in basis step, we are assigning the value for capital A is epsilon, because we can only take the lowest value of parameters in the basis step. So I am assuming the value epsilon for capital A, because capital A is nothing but start symbol of the production. So there are two possible cases. One is the diagram is clearly explained. The first one is capital A indicating epsilon. Otherwise, the capital A may having more than one input symbols. That is nothing but A1, A2, A3 up to AK, which may having any number of variables. So this is the concept of inference to tree, right? So the induction step is nothing but the variable having more than one. So the first step is N is equal to epsilon for basis step. For induction step, N is equal to N plus 1. So the diagram is clearly explained. The first one is A tends to epsilon. This is basis step. And second one is A tends to A1, A2, A3 up to AK. It indicates the inductive step. N is equal to N plus 1. So the second concept is, so this is also the same one, because it is from inference to tree. So the first, there are two cases. The first one is XI indicating WI. WI means it is a set of input strings. That is nothing but A1, alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha k. Another thing, the capital A indicating x1, x2, xk, but x1 having another terminal, x2 having another terminal, xa having another terminal. இது ஒன்றும் இல்லை, இந்த இது வந்து பாஸ் ட்ரீ. இப்போ ஆல்ரெடி நம்ம பாஸ் ட்ரீ நம்ம பார்த்துட்டோம் கிராமர்லேருந்து. ஸோ அந்த கிராமருக்கு பாஸ் ட்ரீ வந்து ட்ரா பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. அதாவது ரெண்டு ஸ்டெப்பில் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இருக்கிறது வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இண்டிவிஜுவல் ஸ்டெப். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், இப்போ இந்த டெரிவேஷன் ட்ரீ எடுத்துக்கோங்க. இப்போ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் என்ன பண்ணிருக்கோம், இ டென்ஸ் டு இ பிளஸ் இ, ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் ஒன். இது வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் மோஸ்ட் டெரிவேஷன். அடுத்து அனதர் ஸ்டெப்பில் இ ஸ்டார் இ சப்ஸ்டியூட் பண்ணியிருக்கோம்ல, த சேம் கான்செப்டை இங்கே தியரமாக கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. ஸோ ஹியர் X1லேருந்து ஆல்ஃபா 1, ஆல்ஃபா 2, ஆல்ஃபா கே, அது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப். அனதர் அதுலேருந்து இன்னும் எத்தனை டெர்மினல்ஸ்னாலும் எனக்கு ட்ரீலேருந்து ஸ்ப்ளிட் ஆகி போகலாம். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கான்செப்ட். ஸோ த செகண்ட் ஒன் இஸ் ஃப்ரம் ட்ரீ டு டெரிவேஷன். ஸோ வி கேன் ஈஸிலி டெரைவ் த டெரிவேஷன், தட் இஸ் இதர் லெஃப்ட் மோஸ்ட் ஆர் டெரைவ் ரைட் மோஸ்ட் ஃப்ரம் டெரிவேஷன் ட்ரீ. இட் இஸ் அ ரிவர்சிவ் கான்செப்ட் ஒன்லி. ஹியர் வி கேன் கோ வித் டெரிவேஷன் ட்ரீ ஃப்ரம் டெரிவேஷன், or we can directly go to the derivation tree, that is parse tree from derivation. It is the reverse process, it is the replicative process only. So the theorem is A tends to W by applying leftmost derivation. So tree to derivation, and also here the proof concept using the inductive principle. So for basis step, we are having the lowest value of parameters. So A is replaced by the number of input string A. We can derive the particular input string starting from the start symbol of the production and go to the input string by applying the production rules with zero or more times, which may be either leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. So in the induction, the height may having more than one. For basis, the height value is zero, but for induction step, height value is more than one, because here we are going to derivation from tree concept. So for basis step, the derivation, the height of the tree is zero. For inductive, the height of the tree is more than one. In this concept, from inference to tree, the A value is epsilon for basis. For inductive, the A value is N plus 1, more than one string for the particular A value. But from tree to derivation, for basis, the height of the tree value is zero. For inductive step, the height of the tree value is 1, higher, more than 1, n plus 1, the same concept. And the final one is from derivation to inference. You all know what is derivation and what is inference. It is a reverse concept. In the first one, we are dealing with inference to tree. Then we are dealing with tree to derivation. And last one is derivation to inference. So the same one theorem, taking the grammar, we variable terminal production and start symbol. If there is some derivation, then there is some inference from the above grammar. So there will be one derivation that may be either leftmost or rightmost. From that derivation, we have to come to one conclusion on the basis of some evidence. That is nothing but from derivation to recursive inference. Here the basis concept having A tends to W. W is the language of a particular head of the production. And for induction, the derivation taking n plus 1 steps. That means we can substitute the value for A, that is x1 comma x2 up to xk, and which leads to the final input string W with 0 or more times, which means by applying the production rules with 0 or more times. So the theorem is proved. So there are three relationships in between derivation and derivation tree. The first one is inference to tree. Tree is derivation tree. Inference is nothing but is a conclusion on the basis of some evidence. Second one is tree to derivation. And last one is derivation to inference, which means we are having some derivation. From that derivation, we are going with some conclusion on the basis of evidence, because here the evidence is derivation. We are already done with derivation, that is either leftmost or rightmost. So it is already done, it is already proved. So from that proved or evidence, we are going with some conclusion, that is nothing but inference. This is the concept of from derivation to recursive inference. So some of the questions based on this lecture: what is a grammar? Each and every language can be represented by grammar. Grammar having 4 tuples. And what is CFG? Context free grammar. It is a type 2 grammar. It should satisfy one important property, that is the left hand side production of the variable should have only one variable. And what are the types of grammar? There are 4 types: type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3. Type 0 is unrestricted grammar. Type 1 is context sensitive grammar. Type 2 is context free grammar. Type 4 is regular grammar. And what is a derivation? List the types of derivation. Derivation is nothing but is a sequence of statements that are start from the start symbol of the production, which leads to some conclusion statement or input string by applying the production rules with 0 or more times. The derivation may have 2 types. One is leftmost derivation and another one is rightmost derivation. The derivation, each and every statement can be replaced by the leftmost variable, that is leftmost derivation. In each and every statement will replace the rightmost variable, that is rightmost derivation. And last one is what is mean by ambiguous grammar. We all know what is grammar. If a grammar having more than one leftmost derivation or more than one rightmost derivation for the same input string for the same grammar, then the grammar is said to be ambiguous grammar.